The big political showdown has erupted after government lifted what appeared to be a ban on government staff in the RSS. Opposition, specifically the Congress party led by Jairam Ramesh, trained guns at the Modi government over lifting this ban of joining the RSS if you're in the, or being associated with the RSS if you're in the government service. AIMIM chief has said lifting the ban is against India's integrity. Sena Uddhav Balasaheb Thackeray has called this lifting of the ban as shameful. But the BJP has hailed it. The Bharatiya Janata Party has praised it and welcomed it, saying it was an unconstitutional order of 1966 that has been withdrawn. Indira Gandhi had imposed this RSS ban in 1966, and that's why it's good and it's timely that it has been taken aback. So the Congress basically is attacking them, saying that the government has lifted the ban on government employees participating in RSS activities. If true, this is against India's integrity and unity. So this is, remember, has become a huge issue because also Priyanka Chaturvedi of the Uddhav Balasaheb Thackeray Sena has jumped on this, saying this with this order, ED, IT, CBI, ESA, other Sarkari offices can prove their Sanghi credentials too, and called it absolutely shameful and against Bharat Mata's interests. So this is, remember, basically what appears to have happened is that the government at the center has withdrawn that there was this notification that banned government employees. If you're in the government service in the country, you couldn't be a part of the RSS activities. Now, with that ban lifted, this, remember, has become a huge showdown. The opposition leaders are asking how and why is this being done. Just to give you a background, in 1965, the then government at the center had imposed a ban on government employees to be associated with RSS. And that has been in an office memorandum, appears to have been withdrawn. BJP has hailed it, saying this was the emergency era notification and there was absolutely no need for it today. So it's going to be, perhaps, will it witness a reflection in the parliament as well? Joining me, Congress MP Manikam Tagore for the latest on that. Mr. Tagore, you tell me, why is the Congress led with standing against the withdrawal of this notification? It's not exactly that they're joining the RSS. You're saying that they cannot be a part of any RSS activity also at all.
So we need to understand that RSS is an organization which spreads hate. And we need to understand that our government officers can't be the places where it can breed hate and against a particular religion or some kind of thing.
Yes.
This kind of thing completely destroys the neutrality of the bureaucracy itself. This is going to be very dangerous and we need to be very sensible. We know that Mr. Modi is in a very sticky wicket and he is in back foot and he has lost the majority entities of this party. They are a minority party and through an alliance they are able to rule this country. And RSS is completely upset with them. Therefore, only to please RSS, they are doing this kind of gimmick, which is completely against the Indian constitution. It is an attack on the Indian constitution itself, which is weak to allow bureaucracy to have some kind of state based organization inside the North Block and South Block to a level of panchayat level is really so dangerous for this country. And they wanted to divert from the real issues. Real issues of this country is 25 lakh students are in road. Their life is at danger. They wanted to divert from that issue to prioritize the issue. The joblessness is so high in this country. They want to divert from the real issues to an issue which is not important for this country. This hate in the offices, in the government offices, is unacceptable. State organizations must be kept away from the government offices, whatever name they come from.
All right, I appreciate you joining us, Mr. Manikam Tagore. Clearly, this could possibly find a reflection in the parliament as well. My colleague Himanshu Mishra is joining me on the latest. And Himanshu, immediately this has become a showdown. Sarkar ka is pe abhi kya kehna hai, Bharatiya Janata Party ka kya kehna hai, kyunki opposition to yahi keh rahi hai ki kaise ye ho sakta hai ki central government ke aap employee of RSS activity mein bhi aap involved ho.
देखिए, बिल्कुल 58 साल पहले जो है ये बैन लगाया गया था सरकार के द्वारा आरएसएस पर कि कोई भी सरकारी अधिकारी जो है वो आरएसएस यानी राष्ट्रीय स्वयंसेवक संघ के किसी भी कार्यक्रम में शामिल नहीं हो सकता है, और अब 58 साल बाद मोदी सरकार 3 के अंदर जो है इस बैन को हटाया गया है कि सरकारी अधिकारी जो है वो आरएसएस के कार्यक्रम में शामिल हो सकते हैं। अभी तक सरकार की तरफ से या ये कहें कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी की तरफ से या संघ की तरफ से जो है इस पर कोई ऑफिशियल बयान नहीं आया है, लेकिन इतना जरूर है कि ये ऑर्डर जो है वो निकाल दिया गया है डीओपीटी की तरफ से। अब डीआईओ में जो है इस ऑर्डर को भेजा जा रहा है, और ये जरूर कहा जा सकता है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी और संघ ये जरूर चाहेगा कि संघ के कार्यक्रमों में जो है वो गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसर्स जो है वो शामिल हो, और इस पर किसी भी तरीके की कोई रोक या प्रतिबंध नहीं होना चाहिए। इस 58 साल पुराने ऑर्डर को जो है एक बार फिर से जो है वो वापस लिया है।
हमारे साथ बने रही है बिकॉज आई एम ऑल्सो नाउ ज्वाइंड बाय बीजेपी'स आईटी सचिव अमित मालविया। Ms. Malviya, you tell me, because Congress MPs and Congress leaders are saying, how is this possibly even permitted if you're part of the government service? How can you be involved in the activities of the RSS? Why is the BJP then hailing this withdrawal of the ban?
What is the problem if any Indian citizen is part of social activities undertaken by the RSS? Secondly, the order issued in 1966 by Indira Gandhi government was wholly arbitrary and unconstitutional. It was in the wake of the anti-cow slaughter protest, which happened on 11th November 1966, in which lakhs of people gathered around the parliament, which was mobilized by the BJP and Jan Sangh, and the police opened firing in which several sadhus and sannyasis died. It was a response to that, that Indira Gandhi imposed this ban on government officers being part of the RSS at that time. It has continued unchallenged for several decades now, almost 58 years. There is no reason why this kind of ban should exist. Every Indian citizen is free to go and work for a social cause that he or she associates with.
But Mr. Malviya, because this would then lead someone to say that they can join some other organizations as well, or they can be participating in activities of other organizations. And Jairam Ramesh, which I want to specifically ask you here about, says the bureaucracy can now come in knickers also.
Look, do you really think that I should be commenting on Jairam Ramesh's IQ and his lowbrow comment and legitimizing it? I'm not going to do it. Secondly, working for a social cause associated with the RSS is not like joining any other organization. Let me remind the Congress party of their own past. Indira Gandhi in 1977 offered to revoke this ban in exchange of the RSS support for her election. Naturally, the support never came after emergency and the ban continued. Also, the first president of post-independent India of the Congress party was closely aligned with the RSS. He had a great equation with M.S. Golwalkarji. And similarly, Purushottam Tandon, the second president of the Congress party post-independence, was a strong advocate of the Uniform Civil Code and the Ram Mandir. So the current generation of the Congress leadership has no idea about their own past, about their own history. I mean, making flippant comments, if that's what senior leaders of the Congress party are all about, then clearly that explains why they've been out of power for almost...
And then, Mr. Malviya, then I'll ask you this, and my final question, what if someone now asks you, what if they join some or are involved in activities of some Muslim organization? It may be controversial, but they'll say this is also a social organization or any other religious organization here. What would then the BJP say to that?
Look, that is the whole problem. The rush to equate things is something quite bizarre. Is there a parallel to the RSS in the country? Is there an organization that has served the nation for almost 90 decades, for almost 90 years, and has done so with an unblemished record? So let's not get into false equivalence. Let's not try and, you know, make flippant arguments. We are talking about an organization that has served the interests of this country for several years. And any kind of comparison, I think, is unbecoming.
All right. I appreciate you joining us, Mr. Amit Walbia. And here's why it's going to become a huge showdown. Remember, you heard Congress MP Manikam Tagore. You heard our colleagues on the ground as well. And why the BJP possibly is defending and appreciating it. Will we see it unfolding in the parliament as well? And what do you think of this about whether it's all right for a government employee to be participating or be associated with an activity of the RSS?